In this lesson, we are further exploring some number patterns, some different ways to predict the next number in a sequence, which again is a list of numbers. Okay. First one we're going to look at is an arithmetic sequence. Here, each term is the sum of the previous term and the common difference. We've seen a few of these, we just haven't called it arithmetic yet. All right. The common difference is how much each number changes to get to the next one, okay? So for this first example, we have a negative 9, then a negative 5, then a negative 1, then a 3, and a 7. And this is arithmetic. We can see that we have added 4, and then added 4, and then again added 4, again added 4. If we want to find the next two terms, then we continue that process. We add 4 to get 11, and then add 4 one more time to get 15. So these are our next two numbers. Now, it also says to find the 16th term. And right now, we're on term 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I could do a couple of different things. I can keep doing this and write out the 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, all the way up to the 16th terms, which would take me a little bit, but not impossible. The other thing that I could do is I can consider, if I'm adding 4 each time, how many more times do I need to add 4? And again, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the 7th term. Our 15 is the 7th term. And to get to the 16th term, I need 9 more terms. So I can think of this as I need to add 9. I need to add 4 9 more times. So in other words, I need to add 36. So I can take 15 and add 36, which would get me to 51. So the 16th term is 51. Okay, so that will work as well. Another thing that we can do is we can look at a formula. Okay, and if we write a formula for the nth term in the sequence, okay, then that means we can plug in any number and find that number's term. So for example, if I want to know the 470th term, I can plug 470 into my formula. And the formula for arithmetic sequences looks like this. Okay, it's A sub n equals A sub 1 plus the quantity n minus 1 times d. And each of these things represents something different, okay? So this means the nth term, whatever we're looking for, okay? So in this case, we did the 16th term. And then A sub 1, okay, this index right here, that number tells us we're looking for the first term. So in that case, it's a negative 9. And then n, again, what term are we looking for? This is the 16th. And then d is that common difference. Okay, so using this formula on this problem, I can find A sub 16 is going to equal negative 9 plus, and then n minus 1 would be 16 minus 1, so that's 15 times the common difference of 4. Then evaluating this, we get negative 9 plus 60, which again gets us to 51. Okay, so either of those options will work. Sometimes it's just a matter of deciding what's going to be most efficient. Okay, the next type of sequence that we want to look at is a geometric sequence. Here, instead of adding the same amount every time, we're going to be multiplying the same amount every time. And that amount is called the common ratio, or R is what we use to represent common ratio. Okay. Here, find the next term and the 8th term. So we have 27 and then 18. Now, I do need to figure out what the ratio from 27 to 18 is. It's not maybe an obvious multiplying by 2 or multiplying by 1/2. Looks like we're doing something else there. So if I'm unsure right off the bat what the common difference is, I can actually take this term and I can divide by this term, and that will tell me my common ratio. So if I do 18 divided by 27, I can look at that as a fraction and reduce it by 9 to be 2/3. So 27 times 2/3 is 18, okay? And then let's check. 18 times 2/3, okay, so let me write that, times 2/3. 18 times 2/3 is 12, okay? Or we could say 2/3 of 18 is 12. 2/3 of 12 is 8. 2/3 of 8 is 16/3. So we have that pattern continuing. To get to the next term, we multiply by 2/3 one more time. And 16 times 2 is going to give me 32. And 3 times 3 is going to give me 9. So my next term is 32/9. For the eighth term, again, we've got a couple of options. We can consider that we are already on term 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the sixth term right here. So we really only need to multiply by 2/3 two more times. So we could say times 2/3 times 2/3, and that would get us to 32 times 2 is 64, times 2 again is 128, and then 9 times, this is another 9, is 81, okay? So that puts us at our eighth term of 128 over 81, okay? But another option, let's say we were looking for maybe the 32nd term instead of the 8th, and we didn't want to just keep multiplying by 2/3. We could use a formula, just like we did on the arithmetic sequence, to find the nth term. In this case, n is 8. So the geometric sequence formula is a sub n, okay, so the nth term is equal to a sub 1, again, that means the first term, just like it did up above, and then times the common ratio, which is r, in this case it's 2/3, raised to the n minus 1. The reason we do n minus 1 both on this term, or this formula and the previous formula, is that on the first term we haven't added the difference or multiplied by the common ratio yet. It doesn't happen until the second term. So we're multiplying by 2/3 one less time than the number of terms that we have. Okay, so for our example, okay, the eighth term, so a sub 8, is equal to a sub 1, which is 27, times, and then our common ratio is 2/3, and we are raising that to the n minus 1, so that's going to be the seventh, okay, and I already know what that's going to be, so I don't need to compute. It's going to be 128 over 81. So again, either way that we want to do this, either by continuing to find the, you know, consecutive terms till we get to the one we need, or by using the explicit formula, will work. I will recommend that you commit both of these formulas to memory, because these are important ones that show up frequently. All right, the next method is using what's called successive differences. Okay, sometimes the difference between each of the consecutive terms in a sequence is not the same, but it does create a new sequence. Okay, so the differences of consecutive terms creates a new sequence, and then we can look at that sequence and look for another pattern with differences. Maybe that has differences, or the same difference in the second sequence. Maybe we need to go to a third sequence or a fourth, but eventually we should, with this type of sequence, we should be able to get to a common difference. And let me show you what I mean. To do this, I'm going to take the terms, okay, I'm going to take all of these terms and space them out a little bit to give me some working room. So 3, 14, 31, 54, 83, 118, okay? And I'm looking for the differences between each pair of terms. And I'm going to put that below, okay, kind of in the middle here. So the difference between 3 and 14, that's adding 11, so I've got a positive 11 here, okay? From 14 to 31, that's a difference of 17, okay? And make sure that you're subtracting the latter number minus the former number. So in this case, 14 minus 3 and 31 minus 14. We don't want to switch it up and do 14 minus 31 because that would give us a negative 17, so we need to go the same direction, new minus previous. And then from 31 to 54, again, we subtract, we get 23. Okay, 83 minus 54 is 29. And then 118 minus 83 is 35. Okay, so that's not the same number every time, meaning I haven't gotten to where my pattern is yet. So I'm going to repeat this process. Okay, I'm going to now look at this row as a new sequence. Okay, and I'm going to look at the differences in the terms for this row. So doing what I did above, now I'm looking at 11 and 17. From 11 to 17 is adding 6, so we have a difference of 6. From 17 to 23, again, that's adding 6. From 23 to 29, looks promising, it's adding 6 again. 29 to 35, again, we've added 6. So once we get to a row where all of the terms or all of the differences are the same, okay, or the terms in the new sequence, in this case the third sequence, are the same, then we can work back up to get the number that comes after 118. And remember, that's our goal, is to figure out what is this number right here. Okay? So to do this, switch colors again here. To do this, I'm going to start down at my 35, okay? And I'm going to figure out what goes right here, okay? Well, I know the difference between 35 and the next term is going to be a 6, so I'm going to do 35 plus 6, and this is a 41. And then 41 is the difference between 118 and the next number in the original sequence, which is what I'm looking for, and that number then is 159, and that's my answer, 159, okay? Sometimes we may need to apply this process more than once. Maybe if the third row were, if these numbers were not all the same number, I would need to go down to the fourth or maybe even the fifth row. But eventually, if the numbers fit this pattern, okay, and generally it will indicate that you should use successive differences, but if the numbers fit this pattern, we will get to a row where all of the terms in the new sequence are the same, and then we can work back upward to get to the original by adding. The last type of numbers that I want to look at here are figure-it numbers. Okay, and it looks like something has shifted. Sorry about that. Had to pause the video. Okay. Let me shift this a little bit. All right, there it is. Figure-it numbers. Okay, figure-it numbers are numbers that match the number of dots needed to create the next iteration, which really just means layer, okay, in a pattern, in this case a geometric pattern. So the first two sets of figure-it numbers are triangular numbers. Okay, and as you can see, we have a 1, and then 3 dots makes a triangle, and then when we add another row, we get 6, and then we're adding a row of 4 to get 10, etc. And then the square numbers, we start with 1, and then we need to add these 3 to get 4, and now we need 5 more to get 9, and then, again, adding layers all the way around, we get 16. Okay, so we have triangular and square numbers are the first two types of figure-it numbers, and we don't need to necessarily draw, like continue drawing the figures. We actually have formulas that will find the nth term in the triangular or square numbers. So I'm going to use the formula for our triangular numbers as an example here because I want the 8th and the 14th triangular number. So I want when n equals 8 and when n equals 14. Okay, so here's the formula for triangular numbers. It is t sub n equals n times n plus 1 over 2, okay? And so then for the 8th triangular number, I'll let n be 8. So t sub 8 equals 8 times 8 plus 1 is 9. And then I need to divide that by 2, okay, which I'm going to reduce that to a 4, gives me 36. So the 8th triangular number is 36. And for the last one, we want the 14th triangular number. So t sub 14 is going to be 14 times, and then 14 plus 1 is 15. And again, dividing by 2, and I'm going to reduce here. So I have 7 times 15, which is 105. So that's my 14th triangular number.